ComfyUI is going to transition to a new era starting August 15. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I wanted to bring your attention to this post here. This is the official ComfyUI post, and it's mentioned here that the ComfyUI front end is going to get a new transition, a new skin, and it's going to be modernized. In this post here, it says that effective August 15, 2024, the legacy version, so the version that you probably have right now, will become deprecated, and then a new version, a new ComfyUI front end, will take its place. And this transition is because they are moving from the JavaScript as the front end to a new front end using TypeScript, Vue, Vite, and basically, if you've done any kind of front end coding, you know that it's now more robust and it's easier to maintain, as well as provide more features, accessibilities, and so on. Now, a quick preview of what you will get. And by the way, if you want to, you can get an early version of this. I will show you how to do it, but just a quick preview of what you can expect to have in that new front end. So here it is. And as you can see, it looks exactly like the original one or the legacy version, but there are a few improvements done to the UI. And this is not going to impact your image generation. It's just the front end that is being reworked. So one thing that's actually frustrating is when you are trying to look for a particular node, usually you will double click and then search for it and then try to figure out which one to use. Now, when you double click, it will give you this nice context menu where on the left side, you will get a preview of the different nodes. So as I am hovering over it, you can see that it's giving me a preview. We have a nice interface, it's modern looking, and we can just search for anything that we are looking for. It's going to do the search, and you can just select it from the list. This is just one of the improvements. I'm not going to extend this video too much. Basically, the information is already available in this post. I'm going to leave the link in the description below, and you can go ahead, look at all the changes and read everything in detail. In summary, what you can expect to have is a sidebar, as you can see here. We go down, we have a node list filter. There's also a new sidebar where you can see the queue, the history directly from there. We've already talked about this node search box, and it's also fuzzy search. Basically, if you, let's say you need to search for something like the clip text encode, you can search for CTE and it will do a fuzzy search for the first letter of each word and then give you that particular node. There's also improvement when you are linking the node, it will automatically correct itself, select the correct position. And I believe it shows in one of the videos here. This one here, it says auto-correct itself to the correct slot. So you can watch these videos and see what to expect in the new release. And for developers, so if you would like to make use of the sidebar, this is the API that you can register to the sidebar tab. Now, going down, you will see the roadmap, what has been completed, and what's to be done. Now, for those of you who would like to test out this new version, you can test it right now inside your ComfyUI. It's not going to break anything. And if you want to go back to the legacy version, I will show you how to do it as well. So in this post itself, if you scroll down, there is a how to use. And if you're using the Windows portable version, simply copy this line here. If you are running ComfyUI independently by using Python main.py and then adding your own argument, then copy this argument here and then paste it in your command line. I am using the Windows standalone portable version, so I'm going to copy this line. You can click on this copy icon and then go into your Windows File Explorer, navigate to ComfyUI where there is the run CPU and run NVIDIA gpu.bat file. Open the file, you can right click and select edit in Notepad. You don't need any fancy code editor for it. It will open it and then simply control A to select everything and then control V to paste the new code. It should look something like this. I hope it's visible. All right, it should be something like this. Press Control S to save or go into File, Save, and then restart your ComfyUI. While ComfyUI is restarting, if you see this line here that says Downloading Frontend, and then we have Comfy.org ComfyUI Frontend, you know that it's actually downloading the frontend. And when ComfyUI starts up, you will have the new version. Now, if you want to undo it, go back into that file, that BAT file, edit it inside of Notepad, and remove that end part where it says dash dash front end and anything that is on the right side. Just remove it. Make sure that the pose is below on the next line. So it should be like this if you want to undo it. Again, save it and restart your ComfyUI. Once ComfyUI restarted, double click, and now you should be back to that legacy version. So for me, I'm going to explore the new version. I think I'm going to just switch to the new version right away. It's just going to make the transition easier for me. And that's because I'm going to be experimenting with it. Now, you don't have to make the change right away. In fact, it's mentioned somewhere in the post that they will keep the legacy version. It's just that I'm not sure for how long they are going to keep it and whether it's going to get any updates. So just be aware that there is a new front end for ComfyUI that's coming August 15. All right, so that is it for me. I hope you got some information out of this video. I wish you a good day ahead, and I will see you in the next one.